With so many options available, it can be difficult to find the one perfect typeface that fits just right in a design. The first step many designers take is to narrow down typefaces by classification, that is, deciding whether a serif, sans serif, or script font might be the best fit. But even then, you're left with a multitude of options. Enter the IL1 test. The IL1 test is a quick and simple way to check whether a typeface has designed distinct characters. You'll look at three specific characters in each typeface that you're comparing: the capital I, the lowercase l, and the number 1. Assess the similarities between the three characters in each typeface and determine whether your design would benefit from using characters with a more distinct flourish. The IL1 test is especially helpful when designing interfaces that use alphanumeric data. If, for example, your users are customer support representatives, consistently referencing account or order numbers, having these distinct characters will be useful when communicating with customers. Glancing at these two examples, it's much easier to understand the account number on the left with more defined letters and numbers versus the one on the right, where the number 1 and the uppercase I look very similar. As another example, let's say you're designing a complex data table with several rows and columns of data. Using a typeface with distinct characters will help users more easily understand and differentiate the information that they're looking at. Let's look at a table with several columns of information: model number, serial number, and product ID, all using alphanumeric characters, each with its own sequence of numbers. This first version clearly distinguishes between ones and capital I's, which speeds up comprehension. If I needed to quickly look something up and report this information back, it would be easy to do so. Now let's look at this same data table using a typeface with less distinct characters. In this design, it's more difficult to decipher if these are using the number 1 or the capital letter I without some additional squinting. While these examples both use sans serif typefaces, the IL1 test also works with serif typefaces. Even though serif typefaces have more flourish than sans serif typefaces to begin with, you'll want to pay attention to similarities in character height to help make your decisions. In this example on the left, the number 1 is shorter than the lowercase l. And on the right, the number 1 and lowercase l are more similar in character heights. Having a slightly shorter number than the letter helps me quickly differentiate them from each other. Now, just because a typeface doesn't pass the IL1 test doesn't mean it's a bad typeface. It just may not be the best fit for content living in data tables or more complex body copy. For example, this font does not pass the IL1 test, since these characters share very similar characteristics. So I wouldn't want to use it in this data table. But if I instead make use of it in my headers, I can still incorporate the personality and the charm of this typeface into my design. Typography is complex, and it takes time to truly grasp. The IL1 test is just another tool in your toolkit to help aid your early design decision-making process.